An electronic device dissipating 35 watts has a mass of 18 grams and a specific heat of 790 joules per kilogram degree Celsius. The device is lightly used and it's on for 4 minutes and then off for several hours, during which it cools to the ambient temperature of 20 degrees Celsius. Determine the highest possible temperature of the device at the end of the 4-minute operating period. How would your answer change if the device is now attached to a 0.4 kg aluminum heatsink? Assume the device in the heatsink to be isothermal. This is the first example for the specific heat for incompressible substances main lecture video. The links to that 11-minute video, the other examples for this topic, and the other lectures of the thermodynamics course are found in the description below. The examples on this topic are innately of lower difficulty. Since what we learned was that for incompressible substances, there is only one specific heat, not two, we're basically back to the type of problems you solve during courses like physics or chemistry. In thermodynamics, we will usually assume solids to be incompressible, so this electronic device and heatsink will only have one specific heat. From the conservation of energy equation, we see that if our control volume is the device itself, the energy that it is generating has to be equal to the change in internal energy. There's no other terms here. The energy would be equal to the rate of energy W dot times the time it's on for in seconds. The change in internal energy would be equal to the mass of the device times the specific heat times the change in temperature. Since we're being told that the device is not used for a long enough period for it to cool down to the ambient temperature of 20 degrees Celsius, that will be our initial temperature when the device is turned on. With this expression, we can solve for T final, we can substitute all values, and find that the temperature of the device would rise to 611 degrees Celsius. Now, what would happen with the heatsink? Since we are told to assume the device and the heatsink as isothermal, meaning having the same temperature, we can take our control volume to be the device and the heatsink together. The generated energy would not change, but the change in internal energy would be that of the device plus that of the heatsink. We have the mass, and we can look up the specific heat for aluminum around 300 Kelvin. The temperature is a bit lower than 300 K, but since we expect the heatsink to rise in temperature while the device is on, it's okay to take the specific heat for that value. We factor out the change in temperature, since both objects are isothermal, solve for the final temperature, substitute the values, and find a final temperature of 42.4 degrees Celsius. This shows the importance of having a heatsink for devices that use a lot of power. We went from the device reaching 611 to only 42 degrees Celsius. Of course, you'll learn a lot more about devices like these in a heat transfer course. Link to that course in the description below. If you want to watch some other examples on this topic or the other lectures of the thermo course, as well as other engineering courses, make sure to check out the links in the description below. Thanks for watching.